See, in the previous class, we have started foreign currency conversions, foreign currency business transaction conversions, so in this case we have done the step up to step number 2, right? Then step number 3, enter exchange rates. Every day the user has to enter what is the bank buying rate of every foreign currency, what is the bank selling rate of every foreign currency, and what is the average rate of every foreign currency we are dealing with. So for this purpose we can use different methods. The user can enter the rates every day manually, or we can prepare one Excel sheet with the bank buying rate, bank selling rate, and bank average rate for each foreign currency we are dealing. That Excel sheet can be uploaded. Otherwise, there are some internet sites like www.moneycontrol.com, www.xe.com, www.iforex.com, www.bloomberg.com. Like that, we have many internet sites. So if you pay the subscription to those internet sites, and these internet sites will deal with the foreign currencies. So these internet sites will be updating foreign currency rates every day. So whenever they update the foreign currency rates, they also will be automatically flown into your database. For that, we have to pay some subscription to these internet sites, and they will send us some small plugin. Then the basis consultants will install that plugin in the client servers. As a result, the updated foreign exchange rates from these sites will be flown into our database. So here we don't have all these facilities. That's why I am going to show you how to enter the foreign exchange rates for each foreign currency manually. SPRO, SAP NetWeaver, General Settings, Currencies, Enter Exchange Rates. Click on New Entries. Exchange rate type is equal to G. Bank buying rate. Valid from today is 7th December, right? 7/12/2015. Then indirect quotation is, let us say, 64. What is indirect quotation? I will explain. Indirect quotation is equal to 64. From is equal to INR to USD. Then exchange rate type is equal to B, bank selling rate. Valid from 7/12/2015. Indirect quotation 66. From is equal to INR to USD. From is equal to INR to USD. Then M. Exchange rate type is equal to M. Valid from 7/12/2015. Indirect quotation is 65. 64 plus 66 divided by 2. 65. Average rate. From is equal to INR to USD. Click on save. Now, here we have to enter bank buying rate, bank selling rate, average rate for each foreign currency in which we are incurring the business transactions. Suppose if you are dealing with the 10 currencies, 10 into 3, 30 rates are to be entered every day. Okay, then here you have the two types of quotations. Like number one, indirect quotation. Number two, direct quotation. Technically speaking, we can enter either direct quotation or indirect quotation. But only the difference is only the matter of convenience, right? But for that, we should understand what is indirect quotation and what is direct quotation. See, foreign currency postings, foreign exchange quotations. There are two types of quotations which we can enter in the foreign currency tables. Number one, so first I will explain indirect quotation, because we have entered indirect quotation, right? Indirect quotation. For one unit of company code local currency, how many number of units of foreign currency? See, for one unit of company code local currency, how many number of units of foreign currency? What is the company code local currency here? US dollar. So for $1, how many rupees you get? That is foreign currency. 66, 65, 67, like that. So it is convenient to use the indirect quotation when the company code local currency is bigger than the foreign currency. So our company code local currency is USD. It is bigger than foreign currency Indian rupees. That is why I have entered indirect quotation. Then what is direct quotation? Reverse, for one unit of foreign currency, how many number of units of company code local currency? For one rupee, what is the foreign currency here? INR. So for one INR, how many dollars you get? 1/65, 1/66, 1/64, like that, which will be coming into decimal values. It is convenient to use the direct quotation when the foreign currency is bigger than the company code local currency. Here, the company code local currency is bigger than foreign currency. That's why I have used indirect quotation. But suppose if you are going to enter the rates for GBP, foreign currency is bigger than company code local currency, INR. So in that case, we enter direct quotation. It's only a matter of convenience, right? Then another term you have to understand is transaction currency. It is the currency in which the business transaction occurs. It is also called the document currency. The document currency or transaction currency, both are same. For every foreign currency posting, the system stores two figures. One in the document currency and the other in the company code local currency. So this I will show you after posting the transactions. See the next step. Post a document in foreign currency F-02. Before doing this, I am just checking one setting. What is that setting? I will explain you after posting the transaction. B is there. Okay. Now, transaction code F-02. Document date is 7/12/2015. Type is SCA. Company code 1060. Posting date 7/12/2015. Period 12. Currency USD. Posting key 40, account is currency not USD, INR. We have incurred the business transaction foreign currency, no, Indian rupees. Here, the assumption is our landlord is in India, so he wants the payment in Indian rupees. So we have made the payment of rent in Indian rupees. That is the assumption here. So currency INR. This is called document currency or transaction currency. Now, the question here is, how the system understands whether this INR is foreign currency or our own currency? At the time of posting every transaction, we are entering the currency here, right? And we have defined the currency at the time of defining company code. That currency is called company code local currency and US dollar. So every time the system will compare the currency entered here with the currency entered for the definition of company quote. If both the currencies are same, system understands that, okay, this is my own currency. Suppose if the currency entered here is different from the currency entered in the company quote, then the system understands that, okay, this is the foreign currency. Then it will convert those foreign currency into company quote local currency. So account is 4,300,000. Click on enter. See here, see the error message. For document type SA, an entry is required in the field document header text. See here, I am taking you to document type SA, OBA7. Click on position, document type SA. See, required during document entry. Somebody should have selected this document type header text. That is why it is asking for the document header text. Now I have deselected this. Click on save. You have to go back and come again. F-02. Document date is 7/12/2015. Currency INR. Posting key 40. Account is 4,300,000. Click on enter. Amount is 66,000 INRs. See, against the amount, there is INR. Business area 1060. Text being rent paid. Posting key 50. Account is 2,100,000. Click on enter. Amount is asterisk. Business area 1060. Text place. Click on save. Now go to menu document display. See the material. Go to menu document display. See rent account data to cash 66,000 and currency INR. This is called foreign currency or document currency or transaction currency. Now, this amount 66,000 should have been converted into company code local currency US dollar. So, what is the amount in the US dollar? Click on display currency. If you see the material, see the material. Important note. Sorry, here. Click on display document overview icon, make corrections if necessary, and click on save button. Go to menu document, click on display option. Then click on display currency to see the amount in the local currency also. See, amount $1,000. Means system has taken 66 rupees per dollar, which is bank selling rate. So why the system has taken the bank selling rate? Why it has not taken bank buying rate or bank average rate? Where the setting is done, I will tell you. See the material. Important note. Whether a particular document should be posted at exchange rate type GBM value is decided by its document type SA. SA means general ledger document, KR, vendor invoice, DR, customer invoice. We have to decide and assign default exchange rate type to the document type OBA7. Then procedure to assign default exchange rate type to the document type transaction code OBA7. Okay. Go to the transaction code OBA7. Click on position. Document type is equal to SA. Click on enter. Select document type SA. Click on details button. See default values. Exchange rate type for foreign currency documents B is there. That's why system has taken 66 rupees per dollar. Suppose if I change it to G, bank buying rate, from now onwards the system will use the bank buying rate for the purpose of foreign currency conversions, and the previously posted transactions will not be affected. Only the transactions which you post from now onwards will be converted using bank buying rate. Click on save. Now I will post one transaction. Again I will show you. F-02. Document date is 7/12/2015. Type is equal to SA. Company code 1060. Posting date 7/12/2015. Period 12. Currency USD. Posting key 40. Account is 4,100,000. This time we have paid salaries in, I'm sorry, currency INR, I'm sorry. Account is 4,100,000. Click on enter. Amount is 65,000. Just to make the calculation easy, I am using the whole amounts. Business area 1060. Text being salaries paid, posting key 50, account is 2,100,000. Click on enter. Amount is asterisk. Business area 1060. Text plus. Click on save. Now let us display the document. See, salaries account data to cash 65,000. Click on display currency. 65,000 bank, oh, I'm sorry. I have entered 65,000, right? Anyhow, 65,000 divided by bank buying rate is what? 64,000. So here, let us do the calculation. Sixty-four is the bank buying rate, right? Enter. 1015.625. It has rounded off. 1015.63. That's how from now onwards the system takes the bank buying rate for the purpose of conversion. Okay. Now let us see in which currency the line items are displayed. Right. I am taking you to the cash account line item display. FBL3M. GL account is 2,100,000. Click on execute. See, 1015.63. So the system will display the line items in foreign currency only. Sorry, in the company code local currency only. Why so? For every account, we have selected display balances only in local currency. That's why the system will display the balance of the GL account in the company code local currency only. For that purpose, whenever the foreign currency business transactions are posted, they are converted with the help of the settings we have done. See, here I have given something in the material like, see, not here. See, whether a particular document should be posted at the exchange rate type GBM value is decided by its document type SAKRDR. So we have to decide and assign default exchange rate type to the document type OBA7. Here, generally, what happens is the general ledger documents are converted using bank average rate. Then vendor invoice are converted using bank selling rate. Means, in order to make the payment to vendor, we have to purchase the foreign currency. Our purchase means bank selling. That's why for document type vendor invoices, generally we use bank selling rate. But for customer invoice, we use bank buying rate. Clear? This is a general rule, right? But based on the specific requirements of your client, we can assign either bank buying rate or bank selling rate or bank average rate for the respective document types. How to assign? I have shown you, know. In that way, we can assign. This is the concept of foreign currency conversions. Any questions from anybody? Now, interest calculations, right? So, I will explain what is the function of interest calculations, right? Just give me 1 minute. Yes. So, what is the function of the interest calculations? First, we'll explain. See, we have taken one term loan, right? Then, we have to repay installment every month first. Then, before paying the installment on first of every month, we have to calculate interest on the outstanding balance of the term loan. That interest amount is to be debited to interest account and it should be credited to term loan account. So if you don't follow this calculation, if you don't do this calculation, then what happens? There is the difference in the balance shown in the term loan account in our books and the balance shown in the bank books in our term loan account. That's why it is compulsory that you have to calculate interest and the interest amount is to be debited to interest account and that is to be credited to term loan account. And also, the term loan installment contains some amount towards the interest and some amount towards the principal. So, we should know what is the amount that is paid towards the interest and what is the amount that is paid towards the principal. Suppose, you have the 50 term loans. And let us assume on first of every month, you have to pay installments of 50 term loans. So as on the last day of every previous month, we have to calculate interest on all the 50 term loans and we have to post 50 accounting entries. And on each term loan, you are paying different rates of interest. In that case, calculating interest on 50 term loans and also posting 50 entries is a time-consuming process. That's why SAP has developed some configuration settings. So during the implementation projects, the FI consultant will configure all the settings in the client company and the person who is responsible to calculate interest, he executes one transaction code. And in that transaction code, he enters the information in 7 to 8 fields. Then the system automatically calculates the interest on all the 50 term loans and it will post all the 50 accounting entries. This is the function of the interest calculations, right? Now, for that, I'm going to show you the configuration. See the first step, define interest calculation type. So what is the interest calculation type? See, in SAP, there are three types of interest calculations. Number one, balance interest calculation. Number two, item interest calculation. Number three, penalty interest calculation. These are only the three types of interest calculations in SAP. We can configure only one or all of them, right, based on the requirement. We cannot define our own interest calculation types. So the balance interest calculation type is identified with S, and the item interest calculation is identified with P, with the letter P, and the penalty interest calculation is identified with Z. Then this balance interest calculation is used to calculate interest on GL account balances. What are the GL account balances here? Working capital loans and term loans. Okay, then item interest calculation is used to calculate interest on vendor accounts and customer accounts. Here, why you have to calculate interest on vendor accounts and why we have to calculate interest on customer accounts? I will tell you. For example, today we have purchased material from a vendor for 1 lakh. And he said, we have to make the payment within 30 days. If we delay the payment after 30 days, for the delayed number of days, we have to pay interest. Okay. Unfortunately, due to the funds problem, funds unavailability, we have paid the amount on 60th day, along with the interest. Because according to terms of payment, we have to calculate interest on the delayed amount and we have to pay interest. In that case, you have to calculate interest on the invoice amount. That interest is to be debited to interest account and it should be credited to vendor account. Why so? I will tell you. See, this is the vendor account, right? So we have purchased material for 1 lakh. When you purchase the material from vendor, the entry to be posted is what? Inventory of raw material account to vendor account. So by virtue of that entry, that is posted to credit side of vendor account. Raw material 1 lakh. I hope everybody knows the entries, right? Now, we have delayed the payment and the interest amount is 1000. Okay? So, we have made the payment along with the interest. When you make the payment to vendor, what is the entry we post? Vendor account data to bank. So, to bank 1 lakh 1000. This is along with the interest, remember. Okay. Now, you balance this account. Credit amount is 1 lakh. Debit amount is 1 lakh 1000. So, there is a debit balance of 1000 in the vendor account. Which means that you have to receive 1000 from the customer. Is it really you have to receive that from the vendor? See, there is a debit balance of 1000 in the vendor account. Debit balance means we have to receive from the vendor. Is it really true that you have to receive 1000 from the vendor? Why you have paid this 1000 extra? Towards interest. That's why before paying this amount to the vendor, we calculate interest on 1 lakh and we post the entry interest account data to vendor account. By virtue of that entry, that is posted to credit side. By interest, 1,000. Now you balance the account, balance becomes zero. That is the necessity to calculate interest on vendor account balances, and that should be posted. Similar is the case with the customer account. So whether you have to calculate interest on customer account or vendor account or both, we have to use the item interest calculation type. Then penalty interest calculation. This is used to calculate the penalty interest on the interest due. Means, for example, we have taken one working capital loan. See, the nature of the working capital loan is like this. We have to pay interest to the bank on the amount of the funds we have used during the month. That interest is to be deposited to the bank on last day of every month. Okay, this is December. So, as on 31st December, you have to pay interest to the bank on the amount of the funds used during the month of December. But due to the funds problem again, we have deposited this interest on 7th of January. So for this one week or for this 7 days, we have to pay extra interest on the interest due. The bankers will charge some 1 or 2% extra interest on the amount of the interest to be deposited by us. This is called penalty interest calculation. Right? So based on the requirement, first of all, you have to define the interest calculation types. We are in the general ledger accounting. I am going to show you how to calculate interest on term loan account balances. So first you have to specify to the system which type of interest calculation we are going to use. That is the first step. Define interest calculation types. Path is SPRO. Financial accounting. General ledger accounting. Business transactions. Bank account interest calculation. Interest calculation global settings. Define interest calculation types. Click on new entries. Interest indicator. We have to give one name for the interest indicator. What is the function of the interest indicator? Why we have to define interest indicator? See, interest indicator. This is the identification for which we assign all the values necessary to calculating interest. Necessary for calculating interest. The interest indicator is assigned in the term loan account master record to enable the system to calculate interest according to the value specified in it. Here, in order to calculate interest, we require some values like what is the rate of interest and how many number of days are to be considered in every month. Like that, we require some values. All these values will be assigned to one identification. That identification is called interest indicator. So we define the interest indicator and all the values are linked to the interest indicator. Then the interest indicator will be assigned in the term loan account master record. Then according to these values, the system will calculate interest. That is the function of the interest indicator. So for that interest indicator, we have to give one name. Let us say KL. Give some name. Interest indicator is called KL. Name is equal to 12% interest indicator. Means the rate of interest is 12%. It's only the description of the interest indicator, nothing else. Then interest calculation type is equal to S. If you press on F4, you can see the interest calculation types. Yes, balance interest calculation. Click on save. It says that an entry already exists in the same key, right? Let us say LP. You change the identification, LP. Interest indicative is equal to LP. Now, see the next step. Define this one. Prepare step number two. Prepare account balance and interest calculation. Transaction code OBAA or path is same as above. First, let us do the step. Then again, I will explain. See, prepare account balance and interest calculation. Click on new entries. Interest calculation indicator is equal to LP. This is what you have defined in the previous step. Interest calculation frequency is equal to, so how frequently you have to calculate interest? Every month or every 2 months or every 3 months? That is to be defined here. If you have to calculate interest every month, you have to enter 01. If you have to calculate interest every 2 months, we have to enter 02. If you have to calculate interest every 3 months, we have to enter 03. Okay, fine. How do we know? How do we decide whether the interest is to be calculated every month or every 2 months or every 3 months? It is contained in the repayment schedule. At the time of taking the term loan, the bankers will prepare one agreement, right? That agreement we have to sign. And that agreement contains the repayment schedule. Whether the installment is to be paid every month or every 2 months or every 3 months. If the installment is to be paid every month, we have to select 01. If the installment is to be paid every 2 months, we have to select 02. If the installment is to be paid quarterly or 3 months, we have to enter 03. Just like that, I am entering 01. Then calendar type is equal to G. Within brackets, Gregorian calendar. Within brackets, Gregorian calendar. Then select balance plus interest. Click on save. So, what is the impact of calendar type, right? I will explain. It is there in the notes. See, the explanation regarding the calculation types I have given in the material. Then, calendar type. The calendar type determines the number of days to be considered per period for which interest is calculated. See, the calendar type determines the number of days to be considered for per period. Period means what in SAP? Month. So, in every month, how many number of days are to be considered? That is controlled by calendar type you take here. There are four types of calendars available for interest calculations in SAP. According to requirement, we can use any one of these calendars. Remember, we cannot define our own calendars. Okay, what are the calendars defined here? Number one, bank calendar B. It uses 30 days as the basis for the month and 360 days as the basis for the year. Means, for a while I am stopping the sharing. I will take one material. So this material I will send you along with the class, along with the recording. See, bank calendar. For example, term loan amount to $1 lakh and rate of interest is 12%. If you use the bank calendar, it uses 30 days as the basis for the month and 360 days as the basis for the year. Means, if you are calculating interest for January, system will calculate the interest like this. 1 lakh into 12 by 100. 12 by 100 means rate of interest. Then 30 by 360. even though actually January contains 31 days, if you take the bank calendar, system will take only 30 days. And for the year, 360 days. And for February, if you calculate interest for February, again, it will take only 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 360. Even though February actually contains 28 or 29 days, system will take 30 days for the month. Similarly, when you are calculating interest for April, the system will take 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 360. Whatever may be the month for which you are calculating interest, system will take only 30 days uniformly and 360 days for the year. This is the impact if you take the bank calendar. It doesn't mean that you have to take the bank calendar. Based on the requirement, we can take any calendar. Here, if you press on F4, you can see the calendar types. B. B for bank calendar. 30 by 360. Right? Then, number 2, French calendar. It uses the actual number of days in a month as the basis for the month and 360 days as the basis for the year. Means, see, French calendar F. It takes the actual number of days in a month as the basis for the month. January. When you are calculating interest for January, it will calculate like this. 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 31 by 360. Because actually January contains 31 days. Then February. If you calculate interest for February, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 28 by 360. Because February actually contains 28 days. But if it is a leap year, system takes automatically 29 days. And if you are calculating interest for April, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 360. Because actually April contains 30 days. Here, January is the example for the month containing 31 days. February is the unique month. And April is the example for the month containing 30 days. That's why you have to understand here. I cannot give the 12 months example. No, that is the reason. Then, you have Gregorian calendar, G. It uses the actual number of days in a month as the basis for the month and 365 days as the basis for the year. See, when you are calculating interest for January, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 31 by 365. February, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 28 by 365. April, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 365. That is why I have taken Gregorian calendar just like that. Now, we have the Japanese calendar, J. It uses 30 days as the basis for the month and 365 days as the basis for the year. Means January, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 365. February, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 365. April, 1 lakh into 12 by 100 into 30 by 365. So, month uniform, but for the year, it takes 365 days. That is the impact if you take different type of calendars. This slide I will send you along with the recording. So, I have taken G, Gregorian calendar. These are the four calendars I have given here. And of course, if you press on F4, you can see the calendars easily. J means Japanese, 30 by 365. F means 2831, means actual number of days in a month. Okay? Then see the next step. Define reference rate of interest. So, what is the reference rate of interest? See, it is the identification for which we assign the real rate of interest. That is the actual rate of interest. that is 12%, 13%, etc. The reference rate of interest is assigned to the interest indicator. We can define any number of reference rate of interest. Means, for every actual rate of interest, we should define one reference rate of interest. Suppose, for example, you have 10 loans, right? Term loans. On 3 term loans, you are paying 12% rate of interest. Then on 4 term loans, you are paying 13% rate of interest. On another 3 loans, you are paying 11% of interest. So in that case, for each actual rate of interest, you have to create one reference rate of interest. In that case, 3 reference rates of interest you have to define. So how the reference rates of interest, how the reference rates of interest are used, you can understand in the next steps. For the time being, let us define the reference rate of interest. Path is SPRO, financial accounting, general ledger accounting, business transactions, bank account interest calculations, interest calculation, define reference rates of interest. Let me check the identifications which have been already used. Chandrapriya, can you hear me? Because Rajesh says that he is not able to hear me.
Yes, Lakshman, I'm able to hear you.
Okay. One second. Let me put the message to Rajesh. Yeah, it seems that there was a problem with his internet. Yes. I'm just checking. Because if you use the identification which is already available, the system gives the error message. Okay. L1 is not there. Let us use L1. Because you have used the LP, right? Interest indicator, we have used the LP. So let us use L1. Click on new entries. Reference rate of interest is equal to L1. Give some name. Long text is equal to 12%. Reference rate of interest. In your material, short text is there, right? You make it as description. Rajesh, I think you can hear me. Previously, there was internet problem with you. Description is equal to 12% reference rate of interest. Description is equal to 12% reference rate of interest. Date from 1/1/2015. Currency USD. This reference rate of interest is applicable to the term loans taken in US dollars. Click on save. Then on some of the loans you are paying 11%. So for 11% also you have to define a separate rate of reference rate of interest. For that, just click on next entry button. Reference rate of interest is equal to L2. It is not there in the material. I'm just showing you. Long text is 11%. Reference rate of interest. Description 11% reference rate of interest. Date from 1/1/2015. Currency USD. Click on save. On some of the loans, you are paying 13%. In that case, L3. Click on next entry button, enter the values in every field and click on save. Like that, we can go on defining any number of reference rates of interest. Then see the next step. define time-dependent terms. This is the very, very, very important step. It takes nearly half an hour to explain this step. So this we will see in tomorrow's class. Chandra Priya, you have any questions?
No, Lakshmi.
Okay. Gayatri.
No.
Okay, Rajesh. Okay, Soumya. Okay. Okay, then see you tomorrow same time. Good night and good day.